Hello, it's Kat, and in this week's tutorial, I'll be showing you a quick method of changing your vector graphics into pixel art in Adobe Illustrator. There's only a few steps here, so it is a fairly quick process. Just want to show you my file setup. I've got three layers, a locked dark background color, which is important for the cleanup step, a locked copy on the left here of the flame graphic, just for reference, and then I have an unlocked copy of the flame graphic on its own layer. And the flame graphic itself is just made up of three simple paths with three colors. If you'd like to grab this file to follow along, you can go ahead and do that. The link is in the description down below. So the first step we're going to do is rasterize this flame graphic. We'll go up to our object menu with the flame selected and just choose rasterize. For your settings, make sure you're on RGB to keep those colors nice and bright. Resolution, I just have mine set at 300, which is fine. And then down here in anti-aliasing, just go ahead and make sure that you've selected none. This will help not create extra transition colors between our original flame colors. Go ahead and click OK. It will look like nothing's changed here, but if you pop into your layers palette, you can see this is now an image instead of vectors. This is important because the next step will only work on a raster image that is embedded in your file. So with that image selected, we'll go back into our object menu, and this time we'll choose Create Object Mosaic. Now the section you want to pay most attention to here is number of tiles, because this will be your actual number of pixels or squares of color in our case, because this will be a vector result. So I want mine to be 36 pixels wide, and then the height of 44 pixels has been auto-calculated for me. Now if you do go ahead and change the dimensions in either of these fields, you'll want to click the Use Ratio button to recalculate and make sure that you have tiles that are proportionate to the dimensions of your original art. I'll go ahead and change that back. Click Use Ratio, and then click OK. Now these squares will be grouped by default after you complete that step, and if you go back into your Layers panel quickly and open up your layer, you'll want to just select this image and hit Delete on your keyboard to remove that so that we're just left with this group of solid color squares. Just quickly, I want to note again that everything else in this file is locked, so we will go ahead and select the group, close our Layers panel, head back into the object menu, select ungroup, and now you'll see that these are individually movable. So for the final step, we'll do some cleanup using the magic wand tool. You can hit Y on your keyboard to bring that up, or you can find it in your toolbar under the select tools. Now if you double click on the magic wand in the toolbar, that will bring up the window, and we'll want that visible so that we can adjust the tolerance. I'm going to adjust this all the way down to 0 for now, and just click anywhere on the white pixels. Go ahead and hit Delete on your keyboard. Two things to note for the cleanup step. One is, as I mentioned, the dark background. That's important because it'll help you see where your edges still have some traces of the white background that we need to remove. And the other thing to note is that the color of the layer you're working with has some contrast between the colors of your graphic and your background. You can change that if you need to by going into your layers panel, double-clicking the layer, and then you can just change this to whatever color you prefer, including a custom one if you need to. I'll leave mine on this purple because I can see it pretty well in contrast. Now we'll use our magic wand tool again, and if you hold down shift after making a selection and select another color of pixel, that will add to your selection. And if you want this to go a little bit faster, you can actually move the tolerance up. I'll go ahead and adjust it to about 3, and then holding down shift, I will click on some more of these edge pixels that I want to remove, and then I'll just hit delete. And I'll continue that process until I'm happy with the silhouette of my graphic, and I feel like most of the background color has been removed from the edges. Now what we'll want to do is start adjusting pixels that should be one of the three main colors. So I'll go ahead and pick some of these lighter orange that are appearing in the darkest color, and then I will hit I on my keyboard to bring up the eyedropper tool, and I'll just go ahead and sample that orange. You can continue this process alternating between the magic wand tool and the eyedropper tool to continue refining the graphic until you have fewer colors so that it looks more like genuine pixel art. And if you find for whatever reason that it's grabbing more pixels than you want, don't forget that you can go ahead and adjust this tolerance up or down. The really low levels tend to work best for this process, somewhere between 0 and 3. I'll speed up the rest of my cleanup here. Now that looks pretty good to me, and we're fairly close to just having three solid colors here. And I just want to show you one more quick tip. See how we have this hole here where we've deleted a pixel, and that looks a little funky. I'm just going to hit Z on my keyboard and zoom in on that. And using my selection tool, you can hit V on your keyboard to bring that up. I'm just going to select this pixel next to my empty spot. Holding down Alt, I will click and drag this over just to fill that hole. You can adjust your snapping settings to make this easier. If I go into my settings right now under the view menu, you can see that I have snap to point on and everything else is unchecked. Using that same method, if you see something in your silhouette that you want to correct, maybe adding a pixel, you can go back into your selection tool. I'm going to take this pixel, holding down Alt. Again, I will slide that over and it will snap to the pixels that are already there. And I just want to make that point on the fire a little bit more obvious. So that's the basic process for converting your vectors into pixels in Adobe Illustrator. And now you have a nice bit of vectorized pixel art with clean background that you can use on any color. You can scale that down or export it as a PNG. And I really hope that that was helpful. This is a follow-up to my pixel art video where we paint pixel art using the Live Paint tool. I'll leave a link in the description to that if you'd like to check that out next. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave them in the comments below. I'm always happy to help. As always, have a great day and happy illustrating.